Yeah, I just had not clocked on at that time, like the kind of scrutiny that you come under. Hi, I'm Camilla Thurlow, and I'm looking back at some memories from my scrapbook. So that picture was taken when I went back to Cambodia to film what Camilla did next. That one is quite an interesting one because I was going back to the place where I first started out working for Halo, and it obviously brought back a lot of memories, but it felt strange to be kind of dipping back into a place where I'd lived and worked for so long. I was very lucky to get to go back and see everyone again, and I loved it. But yeah, it was definitely a different experience going back with kind of like cameras and also trying to film in a minefield is quite stressful anyway. So that's what that photo is. So that's me on the right with my older sister and my younger brother and then my younger sister. Yeah, I like looking at those photos from our childhood. We were quite an eclectic bunch. I don't know how my mum did it. We're all pretty naughty, actually, I think, looking back. But I grew up in Scotland and we spent nearly all our time outside. My older sister used to always look perfect for every photo. I think she looks pretty perfect in that photo. And then I look like a complete mess in every picture because I used to refuse to allow myself to be dressed and I wouldn't wear tights. So there's like a picture of me somewhere in Scotland in the snow with no tights on. So I don't think I was the easiest child. But yeah, we just had a really happy childhood. I'm very lucky. And you know what it's like when there's four of you, there's always someone to persuade to come and do something naughty with and have adventures with. So yeah, good. So that's in Nagorno-Karabakh. And that was working in the minefields there. That was my team that I worked with. And it was very cold. As you can see, there's snow on the ground. So it was quite tough going. The training was tough going. I mean, it's scraping through soil that's been frozen solid. So that was interesting. I mean, obviously, I didn't necessarily always understand the language, but it had a real team feeling to it. So I have very happy memories of that time, of being very tired, very cold, but eating amazing food, chatting to people that I really liked, and just feeling like part of something. That is arriving back to, I'm gonna say Stansted, but I don't even know if I've got that right, to an airport, an unnamed airport in the UK, immediately after the Love Island final in 2017. But obviously we came around the corner and there were a lot of people there, including some of my best friends. And it was totally like, that was my first real, I guess, realization that the show had got quite big that year, because it just felt like there were so many people there and quite an overwhelming experience, I guess. But also part of it, I was like just so excited to get back and see everyone again. Yeah. I just had not clocked on at that time, like the kind of scrutiny that you come under when you go to that kind of event. And I still didn't really like having my picture taken, which is why I'm like this in one of the pictures, which I have a lot of photos of me from that time with my hands like this. But I think I just used to think I could do it like for a minute and then I just couldn't do it anymore. I just felt so uncomfortable. It felt so odd to me to be like having my photo taken like that. And I knew we were so lucky to go to certain events, but I don't know, I just would get so stressed before going, so much fear. And then I never really used to like the pictures afterwards because I could see in myself that I wasn't comfortable, and it was an interesting time. But that event itself was one of the nicest events we ever went to because it was all about celebrating everyday heroes. And I remember it being very moving and a really lovely evening. So those are the aforementioned very naughty dogs. But that picture was like our going home picture, because that was when we were moving out. We'd found our own place to rent. and we were taking the dogs home with us, and so I got us all matching outfits. And I did not ever think I was going to be that kind of dog mum, but it turns out I am, and I made everyone dress up. And if you look at that picture, everyone else looks like, oh, why are we doing this? And I look so happy, so excited. So yeah, that was their like going home day in their little outfit. That was me going through my scrapbook. There are more memories in my book, Not the Type, which is out on the 20th of August.